One of the best items you can use for decorative purposes at Dollar Tree are these peel and stick tiles. Sky's the limit when it comes to decorating with these items. I love that they have different styles, including faux tile and rocks. And this one is my absolute favorite. It looks like an antique tin ceiling tile. And there's some really fun ways to use these tiles that I'm gonna share with you today. Hi everyone, my name is Shannon, the Daily DIYer. I'm so glad to have you here today in my craft room creating with me. If you're new and you love Dollar Tree DIYs, hacks, crafting, and home decor, please hit that subscribe button, hit the bell as well, and select all, and you will be notified every single week with brand new free inspiration. Now let's get to creating with these awesome peel and stick tiles from Dollar Tree. Now let's start with a really quick and easy project. You can find these great trays at Dollar Tree. Grab one of those or maybe something similar that you have around your house already. We're gonna use one of the peel and stick tiles to kick this up a notch and give it a high-end look. We are going to line the bottom of this tray with one of those tiles, and to do that we need to flip the tray upside down, measure the bottom, and then transfer those measurements over onto the tile and draw your straight line. So then we can take our scissors, and these cut like butter. They're a super thin, flexible plastic, so it's super easy to cut right through them with a pair of scissors. We're gonna flip our tray back over to the right side, and then you'll have to start making some adjustments. The length of the tiles fits perfectly inside the tray. It is the width that you'll kind of have to cut down here and there until you can get it to fit inside. What I found is hot glue just gets way too hot for these tiles, so I would stay away from that as an adhesive. What I'm using here is a tape runner. It's just a big mamma jamma one, kind of a bigger version of the regular ones you find in the scrapbooking section. I will link my tape runner down below though, because if you use it a lot, this might be a more cost-effective way of using that adhesive. It just goes on cleanly, there's no mess, there's no glue, and it's permanent too. Now, once we have our tile laid down into the adhesive, you can see there's a little bit difference in tones of the tile and the tray, but we're gonna fix that with some of this rub and buff. So this is a really pretty metallic style sort of paint that's gonna make it look more like metal versus the plastic. So I'm just giving everything one coat of that, including all of the sides of the tray, and it just pulls the whole look together. You can use these trays in several different ways. I added some battery powered pillar candles to mine, kept it really simple. It just has a really fancy look to it once we added that tile and the rub and buff. Super cute.
Now you're gonna have some scraps left over from our first project. Don't throw those away, hang on to them. We're gonna use them for this next project.
So this is just a 2.5 inch size strip that was left over, like I said, from the last project. We're gonna use it to create a very simple and easy napkin ring. So literally, if you just cut the tiles in half, basically 6 inches wide, they are the perfect size to use for napkin rings. Again, using my tape runner on one of the shorter edges here, I ran a couple lengths of it to make sure it was good and sticky for me. Wrapped it around to make a circle, stuck it together, and then all you do is slip your napkins right into the ring. So quick and easy, and basically mess-free. So for mine, I just left it plain, didn't paint it or anything, but you can of course paint these if you want or add some more rub and buff to change the color and style. I am gonna be using the same tile throughout this video, but make sure you're grabbing whichever one is your favorite. And we're gonna also grab a glass cylinder vase from Dollar Tree for this next project. We are gonna take our cylinder vase and we're gonna lay it along one of the edges and take a Sharpie marker and mark at the top of the vase. It's basically gonna give us the height of the vase, kind of roll it down to the other end. That'll give you two marks, and you can put a ruler against those two marks to create a straight line, and then take your scissors and cut it out. So now we have the perfect height for our vase. For whatever reason, these tiles only have adhesive around the four edges. So when you cut into them, you actually cut one of the edges off that has the adhesive on it. But if you take your tape runner, run it around or run it down the open edge, and then press the adhesive backing back into place, it closes up that end for you. So that way we can now use the adhesive on the back of the tile, which is what we want to do here. You're going to put the cut edge at the top and the regular edge at the bottom so that the bottom edge is the nice clean edge. And then the adhesive on the back of the tile just sticks right onto the glass. At this point, you can cut that excess off if you want. I use some hot glue here to just
glue the edge down because you're not gonna see it in the back anyway, so it didn't really need to look nice. If you want yours to look nice, highly recommend cutting it to size, and then you'll have a nice clean edge. And then add whatever you want on here. I'm using an antique gold rub and buff. I'll make sure to link the rub and buff along with any supplies I use in today's video down in the description box below, so make sure to check there after this video if you're looking for anything. And in just a few steps, now we have this gorgeous and very high-end looking bud vase. So I put some faux tulips in mine, which I love. They're my favorite flower. You add your favorite flowers to yours.
Have you seen these 10 boards with wood frames at your Dollar Tree? They are such a great find. And we're gonna use a ceiling tile to really dress it up.
If you're wanting to add some cute organization to your office, this is a cute idea. We're gonna take our frame, draw it around the outside edge of our tile, so that way we have a general size to start with, and then we're gonna work our way to cutting down the inside edge, so that way the tile fits on the inside of this frame. Once we get it cut down, we're gonna take our tape runner again and just run it around the outside edges, and then also a few little strips on the middle there. We wanna make sure we have good coverage so that this doesn't pop off. Then we can insert our tile right on top of the adhesive. Make sure to press down firmly. You can leave yours as is. I'm gonna dress up mine just a little bit more, adding a bead of hot glue around the edges and inserting a little bit of macrame cord. That kind of cleans up the edges, just gives it an extra little touch of cuteness too. So the great thing about these frames is you can hang it either way, either horizontally or vertically like this. I decided I wanted mine to be hung horizontally, and there is no actual hanger on the backs of these. So I added my own. I found the center of the top edge, and then these are sawtooth picture hangers. They're super easy. You just hammer them right down into place, and I'll make sure to link those down below for you as well. Super easy. You can hang it on the wall or in your office. These are also magnets that I found at Dollar Tree. The one thing I highly suggest for these is getting some pretty strong magnets, as since the tiles are raised, it's kind of pulled away from the metal behind it. So if you get some stronger magnets, you won't run into any problems.
In our next project, we're gonna make a super chic planter with the help of 4 6x6 inch size white tiles that you can find at the hardware store for only 39 cents each.
You are gonna need 4 of these tiles, and we are going to decorate these up with our tile. So the good thing about these is once you cut them into 4 pieces, basically down the middle and then down the middle of each one again, you have the perfect size to cover up these 6x6 inch tiles. We are gonna remove the adhesive off the backs of the tiles and use our tape runner to attach these onto the fronts of each tile. Make sure to take your tape runner and go around all 4 edges, add a few little strips in the center, and then take your plastic tile, center it on your ceramic tile, and press it down until you have a good connection between both. And here we have one tile. We're gonna go ahead and repeat that process for the next 3. Now you can go ahead and paint your tiles, or you can leave them plain if you want. If you're doing a color, make sure to go around all the edges on the outsides of the ceramic tile so you get a cohesive look. And then I also suggest using chalk paint for these so they'll stick onto the ceramic and onto the plastic tiles. Then we're gonna put this together once all the paint has dried. I'm using some E6000. You're gonna take your first tile, put some glue on the outside edges of that tile, place your next 2 tiles up against it, and then you'll add some more adhesive onto the last tile to create a cube. And then I would also suggest using some painter's tape on the corners until your glue dries and sets up. I let mine dry overnight. And as you can see now, we have one big piece, and that glue sticks really good to ceramic. So use that versus any kind of like hot glue. And then you can use it for a planter. I just stuck one of my plants I already had on the fireplace inside there. I think if I did this again, I probably would paint the inside of the planter too, since you can see inside there. But you could also just paint it all white, and then you could skip that step altogether. It just depends on what style you're going for. Next project, we're gonna grab one of these napkin holders for Dollar Tree for this. They're pretty basic, but if you use one of these plastic tiles, you can really get a fancy look. So this is another piece of scrap that I had. We're gonna take the bottom edge of this napkin holder and trace around the top edge twice since it has two sides. Then take your scissors and easily cut out those half circle shapes. We're also gonna remove the white plastic adhesive on the back of these as it's not attached to the whole thing. And we're just gonna use some super glue for this to attach these onto our napkin holder. So you'll take your super glue and go around the top edges of one side, place your tile on there, kind of let it sit for a few seconds, and then flip it over, repeat the process for the other side. It doesn't take too long for the super glue to dry and set up, so you can use this pretty quickly. Just use it for your napkins in your kitchen area, your dining room area, for a picnic or a party. But you could also use this in your office to collect mail or organize papers too.
Now we're gonna head into the crafting area at Dollar Tree. They have some wonderful wood frame options. We're gonna turn a wood frame into one that looks more like metal.
So once you've picked your favorite wood frame, we're gonna take that all apart, take off the inside, and we're gonna keep the little stick in the back so we can use that later to stand our picture frame up. So remove the inside there, and then we're gonna take a piece of our tile, flip it to the back side, use a Sharpie pen and go around the outside edge and the inside so we can cut that out and have room to insert a picture. So again, just using scissors to cut out the shape along with the inside there, and it'll be ready to go to put on the front of our wood frame. If you're enjoying these Dollar Tree DIYs, I'd love to ask you a quick favor. If you could go below this video and hit that thumbs up button, I would appreciate it so, so much. Once we have our tile cut out, we can take our tape runner again around all of the edges, even these wiggly ones, and also the inside edge of the square for the frame and pop the tile right on top. Again, using some rub and buff here, this is the gold leaf color. We're gonna make this look like a gold leaf frame. The trick here is to make sure you go around all the outside edges. You don't want to miss those. And then come around, do the tile on top, and then also the inside edge of that square. Let that dry, come back in, and do a second coat. Then you'll need to print out your picture to insert into your frame. This is my Canon selfie, not sponsored. This is an item I love having in my craft stash so I can quickly create projects, cards, and decor like this because I can just pick one picture, plug it in, print it out, good to go. I can set it aside for later. So I'll link that down below too. Another item I just have been so loving having in my craft stash this last year. Then we can go ahead, cut down the picture to size, insert it into the frame. I always put my little backer back in there. That's why the doggy is looking at you. I didn't want to see the doggy through our picture. Put the little dowel rod in the back so it'll sit up. And look how beautiful and gorgeous this is. Doesn't look like a wood frame anymore. This is such a cute little decorative item Dollar Tree is carrying now, but we're gonna up it a little bit more and decorate it up so it looks a little more fancy. The love on these signs is covered up with the hooks, so it just didn't really make a whole lot of sense to me. So we're gonna cover it up with the tile, but first we need to take those hooks off the front. So you just twist off a few screws, set those off to the side. We're gonna come in with a scraper and a sander to make sure the front of this sign is nice, flat, and even. We're gonna take our tile and we're gonna go around the house shape of this sign and we're gonna cut out the inside part so it will sit on the inside of the house. Make sure to test fit this to make sure we have the right size and then we can paint this. So I showed you earlier we painted black for the planter. Now we're gonna paint this one white. And again, definitely recommend chalk paint so it'll stick to the plastic for you and not chip. Then once that is dry, take that template and put it on a piece of regular paper, trace it, cut it out. We're gonna use that to help us mark where the holes on this sign are. So lay it on the front, and then I have an owl that I'm using, but you could use like a mechanical pencil end, something pointy that you can then poke into the holes on the front of this sign so we can mark them here shortly. Now I'm using hot glue here to put the tile on here, but I would definitely use the tape runner here instead. This is how I learned that the hot glue was not the best choice for these. Then you'll set your paper template on top, mark those holes with your pointy thing, so that way we now know exactly where the holes are under our tile, so we can reinsert the screws and the hooks onto the front of this little house. And now you can leave it as is if you want, but I never can seem to leave well enough alone. I had these chalkboard tags from Dollar Tree and I added a personalization with some vinyl on the front. If you don't have a vinyl machine, grab a chalk marker. That works too, and you can just write it on yourself. And then we're gonna take some hot glue, glue that to the front. I also tied up a quick little bow and hot glued that to cover up the hole in the chalkboard tag. This is such a cute personalized key hook that you can put in your entryway. This would also make a really cute, easy, but personalized gift idea as well. These are two more ideas using the peel and stick tiles that I used over the winter and Christmas season. If you want to see those videos, I will link those down below. I would love to know which one of these projects was your favorite. Let me know down in the comments below. If you haven't yet, hit that subscribe button so you never miss a new idea here from the Daily DIYer channel. I want to thank you all so much for joining me today, and I will see you in the next one. Have a creative day.